Hey everyone, it's Everything Eve here, and in today's video, I'm going to be teaching you how you can install Windows 95 in VirtualBox. So, first thing you want to do is open VirtualBox, obviously. We're going to wait for it to load there. Then what you can do is ignore this prompt if you get it, and then click on the new machine, and then you type Windows 95, and if you haven't, if it hasn't already, click on 95. And click next, and then it'll ask you for the RAM. Just leave it at that. And then I'll create the VDI. And then what you want to do is you want to go into settings. I just quickly have to modify the acceleration. Then what you want to do is you want to click on the floppy and open. So what you're going to do is you're going to click on the MS-DOS floppy that you chose and leave the disk blank for now and start. It's kind of taking a while right now to open. Oh, okay. So then it'll start Windows 95 and say starting MS-DOS, and then it goes welcome to setup, so you click enter and then enter again. And then click enter one more time because the disk is in the computer already. And now it's going to start formatting the disk drive for use with MS-DOS. Now, MS-DOS is a crucial component to a Windows 95 installation because the Windows 95 disk is not able to boot up by itself. So you will need MS-DOS to run the setup file for Windows 95. Because the setup file runs in MS-DOS, which is a pretty stupid choice, I'd say. But, you know, Microsoft wanted to make that decision back in Windows thing. Besides, Windows 95 was already built on thing. Okay, yeah, it was already built on MS-DOS. So, you're going to click enter for the settings are correct, because you don't need an older date. You can click enter, and then it'll start doing all the files. This is actually faster than formatting. Then you want to click on right-click on the disk image thing and select this too. Leave for a few seconds and then run. Then at 58%, you can right-click on this and click disk 3. Leave it for a few seconds and click enter. And now it should be done. You can remove all the disks from the floppy drive. And once the disk image goes gray, that means you've removed it. Click enter, restart. Alright, now, what you want to do is you want to take the floppy disk thing and click on the disk image that you got for the CD support in Windows 95. Now what you want to do is you want to type A:, and then type install.exe for me. That's what I need to do, and click OK. And now it's going to start installing all the drivers. You click enter, C, and now you have to restart the computer for effects changes to take place. I almost forgot, you have to eject the disk when you restart, otherwise it will not boot in to MS-DOS because it can't run off one disk. Now what you can do is you can go on your Windows 95 disk. So we're going to be using OSR 2.5. Then you're going to type D and then setup.exe. And now you're going to click enter. And now it's going to copy the files at lightning speed. And let's go, welcome to Windows 95. Congratulations. You just click continue. And then it'll guide you through the setup process. And then what it will do is, it will tell you to read the license agreement again. I'll say what I always say, if you're married to law, read it. If you're not married to law, don't read it. Accept the agreement by clicking yes, because the agreement is probably outdated anyway, so that's why I would not read it. I'm just going to X this here and get into the thing. So now, you're going to click next, install in the Windows directory, and then now it's going to check for everything installed on your computer. and check for disk space. You're going to click typical, and then it's going to ask for the product key. So I'm going to type this in quickly, and then, yeah. Alright, so here's the key for anyone who will need it. And I'll also have it linked in the description if you guys can't read this key. It'll ask you for user information, so I'll just type in everything Eeb. And then it'll ask for these. You want to get everything here. And then click next. And then it'll say what hardware do you have on the, and then it'll ask if what do you call it? What hardware is in the computer? And yeah. As you can see, it's actually taking a little while. I decided to do this because it was actually pretty easy, and Windows 2000 I cannot find a key for, and Server 2003 the ISO got deleted when I migrated from my old computer to this new one, So I'm just gonna have to find another Server 2003 ISO that will let me bypass activation. I kind of regret, selecting all that hardware. But at least now it's actually working. So, yeah. So it says if there's no disk activity for a long time, but since this is an emulation, it's very likely that there will be a lot of disk activity and it will not freeze up or anything. And hey, now at least it's done. So then it'll ask for Windows components, and then you can just click. I'm gonna show you the components quickly, so you know which ones there are, and there are these. You can skip these, the Microsoft Asks and Windows Messaging. Just use the most common components. Then it'll ask for startup disk, but you can just click no because you don't need it really. Then it'll say copy Windows 95 files, and yes, you can start copying the files. So, I'll get back to you guys once it's done copying any files. Alright, so the third and final part of the Windows 95 setup is finally here. This is when the computer will restart and finish setup. So we'll click finish. There is no floppy, so no. It's going to say starting Windows 95. And getting ready to run for the first time. Maybe I haven't seen this before. Okay. Oops. Okay, we're running into a bit of an issue here. I just need to probably eject. I'm probably just going to need to eject the disk here. Let's go. Oh, darn it. Guys, I'm really screwing up here. I'm really sorry you guys had to see the error screen. Okay, big mistake I will never make again. Do not leave the disk plugged in, even if it identifies it as a floppy. Just ignore the floppy part, count it as a typo, and just remove it if you have to, because that screw up thing is actually going to happen. But looks like it's working now, so very quick recovery. So I don't really have to crop this part out because it was a quick recovery, and now I'm showing you guys what happens if you do not listen to Bill Gates of 1995. So it's gonna set up any plug and play devices. Now plug and play is basically when nowadays people would just throw something into the computer and then it'll download anything. Back then Windows 95 also had something called Windows Plug and Play, but it only had plug and play for the latest hardware devices. So usually people called it plug and pray because they had older devices that could not recognize as easy as, you know, thing. And it looks like it's actually taking a while. Okay. So now it needs a computer and workgroup network. Default. Workgroup default. No. VM. Then we're just gonna close it quickly. Okay. Now is when we're gonna need to insert that disk. We're just gonna plug in Windows 95 OSR. And yeah, I'll just click on it. And looks like it's working. It's not going to take very long to copy the files, I don't think. Oh crap, it's going to take a while. Guys, it's showing the green light, which probably means it's on standby or something. I'm not sure. Alright guys, whatever you do, do not, what do you call it, eject the disk or anything. Just leave it where it is. Why does it say disk 9? Right, alright, I'm gonna say I'm really, really confused here. It's never done this before. It's constantly re-identifying disks. Okay, so why it keeps on changing the disk number like that, from 1 to 9 to 10 to 14, is because it's acting like, the CD is acting like a bunch of floppies. Which is actually very inconvenient for me. And I'll tell you why it's inconvenient, is because floppies can only hold 1 meg of data at a time. And there are 44 floppies for Windows 95. Annoying, I know. So, because there are 44 floppies, it's actually going to take a while to think, because it has to scan every new disk that comes in. But it actually does look like it's working right now. It's copying the plug-and-play files, if you guys didn't know. I think... Oh, hey. It's actually gonna work now. That's one. Oh, God. Okay, I'm not, I'm getting very frustrated at this right now, because I've never encountered this side of setup before. This is more like the, you screwed up and you'll have to pay, type of setup, so, I'm actually getting frustrated here. What is it doing? Okay, guys, if you guys want to skip later on in the video, I'll have some timestamps linked into the description when stuff actually starts happening. But right now, we're just going to have to buck up our patience and wait for 95 to load. Okay. Oh, thank goodness. I was about to stop recording and edit this part later. But, looks like we don't have to. So, yeah, back when Windows actually used to have a control panel and not some hidden feature in Windows, control panel used to be where you could modify anything. And the start menu is actually kind of weird now. Nowadays we have this big bad start menu that just covers up the entire screen, but back then they used to have just a little button that you could click, and then there's this tiny menu where you could select some shortcuts from. And you can still get it in Vista and lower. It's actually still possible to use the class, and probably in Windows 7 it does too. It's possible to get the classical start menu, the one that's used on this version of Windows. Okay, now it's going to ask for time, and you're going to click Eastern Time. And then close. This will save up the time, save the time and stuff. And now it's gonna ask for printer. We're just gonna click cancel because we don't have a printer. And now we're going to let it restart. But first we'll eject the disk. All right. And it's showing the Please wait while your computer's. And now you notice there's a Microsoft Internet Explorer thing, and the loading is more swift, I should say. Yeah, so this was the first. What the heck? This is what happens when you screw up your installations, people. Stop. Okay. Okay, if it thing again. Oh my crap. I am actually getting so worried right now because this is a big problem. Please, 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 no protection errors. Please, please, please. Please, I'm begging God not to give me a protection error. Right now. Oh, thank God, Windows 95 boots up. So, and this was, I can tell, because I've installed Windows 95 several times before. This was, oh yeah, you have to type your username that you inputted before. This was a trigger reaction, and you can just click OK. This was a trigger reaction for forgetting to do forgetting to eject the disk before you restarted the computer. You should have done that and inserted the disk later. Now it's run through two protection errors. It's gone to and it started identifying as floppies, which took even longer than it was supposed to, and it's generally a little more sluggish than it should be. Right now I'm just gonna shut down the computer because I'm done with this installation. So if you did like this video and my epic fail that happened alongside it, then maybe comment, like, and subscribe, and I'll see y'all next time. Bye!